Hello, welcome to SS Unitech, Sushil this side, and this is continuation of SSIS tutorial. So today we gonna discuss about incremental load, and this is the introduction of incremental load, and it's a very important topic. So let's start with incremental load. Incremental load are used to keep data between two systems in synchronized with one to other. So why incremental load is required? The big challenge is to finding data from OLTP to OLAP. Basically in OLTP this is our transactional database, and in OLAP this is our warehouse. So behind the scene we want to load data from our OLTP server to OLAP server. The target table can be reloaded from the source on a regular basis, but it's bad in performance at the source as well as in our destination. We have different approach by which we can load data from our source to destination. So we can use trigger on the source table. While any entry gets updated, trigger will make the change in our destination table, but it's also bad in performance. So by using incremental load, it load only those data which are not in destination. Like it would be insert only those records which is not available in destination table and available in source table. It will update those records which is newly updated in our source table, and if any record is deleted in our source table, then that record would be deleted. So that's why incremental load are required. So incremental load processes within SQL Server integration services involves lookup to find changes and staging table. In order to update a database due to limitation with OLADB components. So here we will discuss about insert, update and delete. So in our next video we will discuss how we can insert those records which is available in our source and not available in destination. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel to get many more videos. Don't forget to press the bell icon to get the notification of our newly uploaded videos. Thank you so much.